Swapan Dasgupta, please.
Thank you, permitted. Sir.
This debate is on. Please don't intervene, Raman. Please. You have nahi boliye. Kisi ne aapko force nahi kaha. Aapne kuch likha, that is being considered.
Thank you, sir. Last evening, sir, we had the privilege of hearing various very inspirational speeches in this debate. And the gist of those inspirational speeches was that there is no fundamental difference between the struggle for independence and the struggle which is being waged now. Sir, to my mind, this is a rather excessive, exaggerated, and occasionally a rather false narrative. The struggles which were waged by people against a foreign rule, against an unaccountable government, cannot be equated in any manner with any form of legislation or debate which is taken by any government in a democratic country. And I think this is an important point to be made, that the equivalence should not be made. Sir, there was a time when someone threw a bomb, for instance, in protest against British rule in the central legislature. We wouldn't condone such a measure today. It is not acceptable. Sir, I often wonder from some of the speeches whether terrorism really exists or is it a case of fake news? Is it a case that the blasts in Mumbai didn't really happen? Is it really the case that a former Prime Minister of India wasn't killed by terrorist organizations whose praise we have also heard in this house yesterday? Is it a case that the entire Congress leadership in Chhattisgarh, for instance, wasn't wiped out by people who were claiming to be Maoists? Sir, terrorism is real. It is not a nightmare. It is not a bad dream. It is a very real thing which exists in this country. And sir, there is a cat and mouse game which is going on all the time between the security forces, between the intelligence forces and the terrorists. The terrorists have the technology. They have the resources. They have cross-border connections. And they also have a lot of intellectual support. The security apparatus must constantly be one step ahead of the terrorists. And that means constant adjustment, both in terms of legislation and in terms of this. So we, as responsible members, never ask the security forces or the government for operational details. That is something we do not do. Because it is based, the fight against terrorism is based on trust. A trust of the government that they will do everything necessary to protect the people, to protect the citizens of India, to protect the country.
So, Panji, time.
In the past, sir, it is true. A lot of these legislation have been misused, and the various members have pointed to that. That is why I think it is a sacred trust which the legislature accords to the executive to actually ensure that this bill is not misused, but the paramount importance which is there is the fight against terrorism, the fight to protect the citizenry. And with that, sir, I would say we support it, but with the proviso that this is a sacred trust we have placed on
right.
You. Do not misuse
Thank it. Thank you.